Yo, what's going on, and welcome back to Bloodborne. It's been a little bit because I've been playing some Dark Souls 2 with friends. So, it's been a lot of time in that, so I've been using mostly an Xbox controller again. But I also just could not get my capture to work correctly with this for like almost 2 hours now. So that was a little bit frustrating. But I believe it is all working now. And I'm trying to figure out what I should do with my blood echoes. I think we decided that we probably couldn't level up. So we could always. We have over 100 bullets. We could always just buy more blood vials, which I think we're just gonna do. Can we only buy 10? Yeah, we can only buy 10. Oh my god, I just bought one. Okay. And then I still don't know if we want to spend our insight up there. We're not at 15, which I thought was the magical number of you don't want to be above 15. So I think we're okay, hopefully. Although I do think there's some annoying things going on because we are above 10 or some number that I don't know what the number is that could be causing different enemies to spawn and do annoying stuff. Either way, we're not gonna do the Unseen Village right now. It was getting us some pretty good twin bone shards, so hopefully we can use those in the future and we'll go back there. But we did have this boss that we kind of just didn't do. I like the guys with the hats. The hats are way better. And then we also have that elevator area. Is this the elevator area? Yeah, we should go investigate this really quick. See, so yeah, I kind of don't want to go do a boss immediately because it's been not that long. Probably like almost a week since I've actually played this game. I assume we need to go down this. And I don't plan on. Oh my gosh, can we not get back up? I thought there was like a door on the other side of this walkway. I think we're trapped now. We're locked into going down unless we like Bolt Hunter's Mark out of here. That's unfortunate. What a tricky little guy. So I guess we'll go down. I don't really like the idea of going down. But it seems to be the only way we can go right now, so we might as well get all the items that we can on our way down. Which it looks like it's gonna involve. do want to do the boss that we saw next, probably. Oh my. Well, this seems just inconvenient. Is there any chance I can just walk onto this? Oh, thank God. Any other items I'm missing at the moment? Would not appear so. Messenger top hat? Is that better than the hat we have right now? Sounds like it's better. Is there more items? Did we pass an item? I don't know. I thought there were two, but maybe I'm going crazy. There's also some beastie noises. Oh, there's the second item. I see. Is that an enemy? No, that's just random area. Are we just, like, does this just stop here? Oh, no, it goes further down. Are we supposed to make that jump? Because this seems like near suicide. Okay, it's a lot less fall damage than I thought there would be. So what's that guy? What else is in this room? Is it just him? Oh wow. I didn't mean to make it all the way to the bottom, but I slipped off whatever that thing was. Trying to investigate how many enemies are actually here, but I think it's just one. So, let's take them on, I suppose. Get our fighting practice here. Hoped that guy wasn't friendly because he started to stand up right as I walked behind him. He made me panic.
A night of curses. A night to remember. Wouldn't you say, friend?
Weird man. So, we haven't been here, right? I don't think we've been here. Seems new. Oh. The enemies here don't seem too strong, though. Maybe we're just gonna spawn right in there. Same person? Ah, I thought we were further down the way. Whoops. Any items I'm missing? Where's that enemy that we saw? It's right there. Oh, it's one of these guys, of course it is. Thank you. Holy. I don't know why those guys are so difficult for me. They don't seem like the hardest enemy in the world. See how that path back helps us in any way at the moment. So this is a dead end, so there's only one way to go now. Is that guy an enemy? He seems very enemy-like. Doesn't appear to be anyone else in this room. Oh, it's Fire Blood Gemstone. We finally got that weird moon, but I think for our weapon we need triangles. I guess we gotta take that elevator back up and then we try and get back to the area where we cleared out all the people at the very start. This is all a very mysterious area for me. Unless these elevators are. That this elevator isn't under it. It's been known to happen. So yeah, but I want to go here without going back to the Hunter stream or anything. So and we did such a good job of clearing this room out earlier. Still got two bullets, including that bullet that I wasted for literally no reason. Oh boy, I was not expecting that. That was a surprise. I would like to fight them in as few numbers at a time as possible. This guy here. This we can. Be a good answer. Okay, we still got quite a few people over here though. Dealt with. Do this guy? This area was significantly harder than I thought it would be. There were a lot of enemies. Ooh, a message. The sky and the cosmos are one. Why? Interesting. I feel like that doesn't really help me. Bullets, even though they use flamethrowers, huh? What was that noise? I didn't like that noise. Huh. I don't know what any of those do. Are they under, like, key items? For Ludwig successes. Date back to very early age of honor and chivalry. Seems cool. Alrighty. Oh, we're back. We've seen Urn Place before. But I doubt it. Yeah, this is the end of our journey this direction, it seems. So I suppose we'll have to come back up here, which is slightly annoying, but I guess we don't have to kill everything. And this room up here is very easy. That's unfortunate. So guess our next stop is that. Oh wow. That, what an inconvenient ladder. Almost ran out. See, our next stop might be to just go start making attempts at that boss. Oh, I didn't see that chest. circle gemstone. That seems good. Maybe we can equip that. So was there anything else this direction? Because we just kind of chased that thing before we knew what was going on. Yeah, it doesn't look like it. Sage's wrist.
Welcome home, Kod. What is it? Very well, let me.
We do have enough for a level. Do I want a level at the moment? I don't really see how it could hurt. Let's get some more HP. Yeah, sure why not. Again, still waiting for requirements on a weapon that looks good. I should probably save some swords in case we need them. For all this stuff. Garamond's like never around, huh? So how much does this take? We only have 14. But it would unlock that last slot. I'm trying to think if we do that or not. Do we need to repair our stuff? Yeah, a little bit. Let's just repair everything. Oh, do we not have a triangle? Oh, we got a circle one, huh? Ah, darn. I thought we were missing. I didn't think there were this many types of stones. Yeah. That's unfortunate. This does fire attack? Ooh, if we had a weapon that could use that, that's a lot of percent up. What does that mean? HP continues to recover plus one? Do you just get continuous HP recovery? Is that just worded in a funny way? And if we remember, we got some top hats for these guys. Seems like a mistake. Anyways, let us upgrade our weapon to... Oh, we don't have enough blood echoes. Well, we're gonna pop some of these things. Looks like we might need two of the small ones. Use multiple. I don't remember how much these get. I only need one. But yeah, we'll do this, and then that'll unlock another thing that we can put in. This seems to be our best of these spike stones, but what else can we get out of here? Ooh, this one gives HP recovery. It's 2.1. So we can either get 1.1 and HP recovery, which I don't really think is that important. I think we want this one. This one seems to be the strongest. Raise our damage by like 5. Seems pretty good. And let's take off. So I was wondering, up next to like our health and stamina bars, there's like that weird hand with an up arrow. Is that the up on charge rate that we get now? That's what I'm gonna take a guess on, but I don't know that for sure. So we might as well buy another blood vial. So if we use all our blood vials, we got enough for 3 attempts. Let's hope we're not using that many blood vials at a time. We got enough time for a few attempts at this boss. Maybe we can start to learn its patterns. I don't know what boss this is, though. Not that I really know any of the bosses. But we did not go in here earlier and actually check what it is. So yeah, we're just gonna run. Look at their top hats. That is the way to go. We should try and get a top hat. Don't we have a top hat of some sort? We do have a top hat. Seems to be just worse in most ways. That hat's worse. So yeah, we might look into that extra gear that you can buy with the insight. But there's no way to tell from that menu which is better, so I'd actually have to go through and look at all of our separate stats. There's so many stats. Like, this one has a bunch of blue stuff and a bunch of red stuff. I'm kind of just going with this thing that seems average, because this one seems like really bad at some things but really good at some things, and this one seems pretty across the board average. I also still don't know what arcane is. Is there a way? Nope. Okay. Alright, don't press the share button. I'll have to keep that in mind. Sight read it or not.
And feast upon the old blood. There was a wee, mind young, wearing off the field. Death.
Yeah. odd and odd creature. Okay, so this is Vicar of Malia. Definitely heard the name of this boss. So that can't be here. The range I was at the first time. I didn't really learn anything there. Not gonna lie. That I've heard the name of that boss means that either a lot of people don't like it, or it's a cool fight, something like that. Something along those lines.
Disagree. Come on. Get closer to the middle of the room.
Try. Ooh, we're also at 17 insight. So yeah, I did get nervous at the end there. We were running out of blood vials, so I started throwing our Molotovs. It worked out. Oh. Alright. We did it. Whew. That cost us a lot of blood vials, though. What is this? Hands are shaking. Oh boy.
Master Willem, I've come to bid you farewell.
Oh, I know, I know. You think now to betray me.
No, but you will never listen. I tell you, I will not forget our adage.
We are born of the blood. Made men by the blood, undone by the blood. Our eyes are yet to open.
Fear the old blood. I must take my leave.
that? No item? Lame, I wanted an item. What was that gold pendant thing that we got? It's not here. So where is it then? Here. Use to gain a blood gem. What? Which fortifies weapons? Use the pendant passed down among the vicars who head the healing church is a reminder of the cautionary adage, words that will open the gates of a Bjergenworth. So there's supposed to be something to be afraid of in this Bjergenworth place? Specifically, whatever old blood is. And my hands are legitimately shaking. Oh, that fight was so close. So close. I even wasted a blood vial after the fight was over. I was a little bit mad about that. I was like, if she's just getting staggered, and then I was like, ah, no, that throw killed. The eye of a blood-drunk hunter beckons hunters to the hunter's nightmare. A deformed creature will whisk you away. Is that like a DLC thing? Yeah, the turn to mush indicating the onset of the Scourge of Beasts. Excuse me. A hunter who goes drunk with blood is said to be taken by the nightmare. Destined to wander forever, engaged in an endless hunt, it is a fate that no hunter can escape. Okay. What was the purpose of giving me that? Huh. Can we use this? Nope. Stupid altar yet? Nope. Alright, well let's check the shop and see if there's any new weapons in it. Ooh, this is the weapon that I saw on the loading screen. I absolutely need it. I must have it. Trick weapon typically used by the healing church. It is said that the silver sword was employed by Ludwig, the first hunter of the church. When transformed, it combines with its sheath to form a great sword. The healing church worship began with Ludwig and departed from old German's techniques to provide hunters with the means to hunt more terrifying beasts and perhaps things still worse. So what does this take to use? 16 strength, 12 skill. We already have that. Although it doesn't scale very hard with either, so it appears to be like a quality weapon type of thing. Where you want really high of both. So yeah, we're definitely gonna get that, which means we can't spend blood echoes right now. Oh, you can buy upgrade materials in here now. Uh-huh. What else can we buy in here? Oh, we should still probably get this lantern at some point. What other... Ludwig's rifle. What does it do? A rifle typically used by the healing church hunters. It is said that this rifle was employed by Ludwig, the first hunter of the church. It's a long, heavy barrel, makes up in range for what it lacks in reload speed. Ludwig's rifle exhibits several departures from the workshop's design, suggesting that church anticipates much larger inhuman beasts. Interesting. Ooh, we have new gear that we can get too. What is this stuff for? A tire of prospectors who explore the old labyrinth on behalf of the healing church. The healing church traces its roots to Bjergenworth and therefore aware of the ruins' true importance. They contain much more than mere hunter trinkets. Indeed, they hide the very secrets of the old great ones, sought after by those with the insight to imagine greatness. Whoa. I like the hood. I do very much enjoy hood. Oh, I didn't need to exit. Got nothing else to buy, though. I don't know if this is actually better than what we have. It seems like slightly worse in physical defenses, but better in the other ones. If I'm remembering correctly. But yeah, I think we're gonna have to cut it there, and we'll be right back here. We're definitely going for that sword, so we might go out and farm up 5,000 souls by exploring a little bit. Souls. Blood echoes, I mean. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll see you next time.